Aljunied GRC, friends and fellow Singaporeans, all eyes on Aljunied at this election, because the Workers' Party is going head to head with the PAP again. The Workers' Party and I agree that the party should best serve you by us forming a GRC team to contest in Aljunied. This is for the future of democracy in Singapore. We must make a breakthrough in this election. We bring you a strong, competent group of candidates, and we believe we can do it together with you, the people of Aljunied. The candidates that we have for you to choose, besides myself, are my party chairman, Silver Lim, Ken Sobao, Pritam Singh, and Muhammad Faizal. Generational change of leadership. Some analysts predict that this GE will be very tight. Other analysts bet that the men in white are always right. In other words, the PAP will win this election. What do you think? Will the PAP win all six in this election? Do you think you will have a better future if PAP wins all seats? Yes, we agree this will be a watershed election. But it's not because of change of leadership. Every general election is about change of leadership. The generational change of leadership the PAP is referring to is a change within the PAP. We must not confuse PAP and the government. Yes, the PAP has formed the government in Singapore for 51 years. But even Lee Kuan Yew has said, I quote, "There will come a time when eventually the public will say, look, let's try the other side. Either because the PAP has declined quality, or the opposition has put out a team which is equal to the PAP. And they say, let's try the other side. The day will come. No system lasts forever. That's sure." Unquote. This is from the new publication by M.M. Lee Kuan Yew, Hard Truth. Remember, the hard truth is, no system lasts forever. That's for sure. Yeah. So, what did the PAP do to try to make a system last longer? Let's look at the GRC systems. You may be wondering why I decided to contest in a GRC to seek a breakthrough. What is so significant of breaking through a GRC that the Workers' Party is going for broke? Why is it so important that I need to leave Aljunied, a constituency I served for 20 years, and I built a strong rapport with the people there, with a lot of friends and memories. The PAP government introduced a three-member GRC in 1988, general elections. They explained that the need for GRC system was to make sure that there is minority representation in parliament. But no PAP minority candidate, from what I know, was voted out because Singaporeans vote along racial lines. On the contrary, the former Secretary General of the Workers' Party, Mr. J.B. Jeyaretnam, who is not a Chinese, was voted into Parliament in 1981 by-election in Anson constituency, which is a Chinese majority constituency. If you recall, following the Workers' Party breakthrough in 1981, there was also a big swing against the PAP in general election 1984. And another opposition, Mr. Chiam See Tong, was elected. I think we all know that the GRC system was in response to the vote swing against the PAP. A big part of the Anson constituency was merged with Radin Mas, Henderson, and Tiong Bahru to form Tiong Bahru GRC. Another part goes to Tanjung Pagar GRC. The anchor person at Tiong Bahru GRC at the point in time was a senior minister of state who had been in Tiong Bahru for 20 years. I stood as a candidate in Tiong Bahru GRC in 1988 general election. That was my first election. As expected, at the counting center, my suspicion was confirmed. Had Anson or Radin Mas remained as a single seat constituency, I could have won the election because, based on my estimate, Tiong Bahru constituency delivered the strongest support of at least about 70% for the PAP. But because of the GRC, my team only got 42% of the very vote casted. I lost the election. Over time, we have seen GRCs grow. I believe this is because the PAP realized that with three-member GRC team, the opposition still stood a good chance of being elected. So they have to tweak the system further. And the GRC becomes like rubber bands. What elastic? They increase from 3 to 6. Now they are 4 to 6. And they can stretch from Marine Parade all the way to Aljunied. Rather, now, part of Aljunied, in particular, part of this GRC, are now in Amokyo GRC. But we call ourselves Aljunied GRC, but we are now in Aljunied. And as you can see, even the system has tweeted somehow. You heard about chili crab? The two biggest chili crab still remain six members. That's Amokyo, the Prime Minister, and Marine Parade, Senior Minister. Pao Nyawan. Even other GRCs all have at least one or two ministers. Why? Because the PAP knows how you think. That you believe you will be better looked after your minister in your constituency, and hence would rather vote for the PAP to make sure that the ministers get into parliament. You will not vote for opposition candidates, even though you may be less impressed with the other PAP candidates in the GRC. As you can see in this election, a new candidate who has never been introduced before by the PAP appeared only on nomination day and has now walked into parliament to become an MP. Do you know where he is? Anyone? Which constituency? Yes, Tanjung Pagar. Do you think this is right? Do you feel so changed as a citizen with voting rights? I think this is uniquely Singapore. For years, because of the GRCs, many Singaporeans have not got the chance to vote. This time, you do have the opportunity. We ask you to use it not just wisely, but bravely, intelligently, and in a heartfelt manner. I think all of you know what the PAP has been doing. And you have to decide what you want Singapore to be, not just for yourself, but your children and your children's children. Minister George Hill said that the Workers' Party is making use of you, the Aljunied GRC voters, by placing on you the burden of pushing the opposition cause. That we are forcing an emotional dilemma on you to choose between enlightened self-interest and the opposition's interest. This, he said, is against the spirit of democracy. I say, there's nothing more against the spirit of democracy than the GRC. It seems to me what is at stake is the PAP's self-interest, not the voters. And do not forget, this so-called dilemma, this GRC coup, is created by the PAP themselves to control the voters and the opposition in the first place. Let me tell you, that if no opposition is able to break through a GRC, you will be forever shackled under the system. Your power to vote will be just symbolic, and your voice will be limited. The PAP will continue to govern, to bully you, without having to account to you all. The decision is yours to make. Come 7th of May, do vote Workers' Party, and move towards the First World Parliament. Thank you.